cooking in the kitchen at Olam's with registered dietitian Molly Morgan, Olam's cooking consultant.
Today we're making a special kind of pizza. It's a red, white, and blue brownie pizza, which I said I don't really like pizza, but this one sounds really good, so I'm willing to try.
It's a great dessert pizza.
Yes.
And to get started, we just make a basic brownie mix. So head to the baking aisle, pick your favorite brownie mix, and follow the package instructions if you want to add the water. Yeah. This one we're making today just called for a half cup of oil, a quarter cup of water, and then your egg. And I picked a mix that had some chocolate chips in it too.
Ooh, okay, even better. So I'm definitely gonna like this then.
Yeah. All right, and Kara, if you want to bring this pan a little closer.
Sure.
So we've got a baking sheet that I put down some parchment paper on. If you didn't have parchment, you could just use nonstick cooking spray or just something so it's easy to release our brownies from the pan. You want to hold the bowl, I can put our brownie mix on. And we just want to put the whole mix in our pan and spread it into a rectangle. Now, if you really wanted as well, you could do this on a pizza sheet, and in the round shape, you could do your pizza as well. So, either way, it'll look great.
Yeah, and taste great.
All right, and if you want, you can go ahead and spread that out. And just kind of in a rectangle shape.
Oh, and the chocolate chips in these are really big.
Yeah, they're gonna taste great when they melt. Now this would be something fun too if you had little ones around. You could have them help spread the mix in the container and of course mix up your brownies. So it's a great recipe that you could make with your family.
Now do you wanna do it all the way to the edge then?
Nope, you can just kind of get a rectangle shape going, which looks great.
Okay. How's that?
Perfect.
Great.
Now the one difference with this is we're only going to bake it for 20 minutes at 350 degrees because we've spread out our brownies pretty thin. So we'll put this in the oven to let this bake. And then when it's done, it'll look just like brownies, of course.
Yes.
20 minutes again in the oven, and we're going to let this cool, and we'll go ahead and while it's cooling, get our frosting together. So now we're going to make the frosting, and this is a lightened up version of a traditional frosting. So I've got 4 ounces of light cream cheese that's kind of softened up, and I'm going to add in 4 ounces of vanilla Greek yogurt. So it just helps cut the calories, cut the fat. And if you want to add the sugar, it's a quarter cup of sugar. Now you could also use agave nectar or a sugar substitute in its place if you rather. And last but not least is a teaspoon of vanilla extract. Just adds great flavor. And we just wanna keep mixing this so it's nice and creamy and spreadable. Because it is essentially our pizza sauce.
Yes, frosting for pizza sauce, sounds good.
And this is why Kara's gonna like this pizza.
Yes.
Then once our frosting is all mixed up, what I'm going to do is spread this over top, and if you want to get ready with the berries. Now, again, there's no right or wrong way to top this, but I was kind of thinking red and blue stripes. What do you think, Kara?
Of course, red, white, and blue. You gotta do it like that, I guess.
Yeah.
And I like this frosting because I feel like the frosting that you get in the jug, I guess you would call it, it's so hard to spread. So do you want your brownie to cool a little bit?
Yes,
before.
Absolutely. You do want your brownie to cool because otherwise this frosting will just start to melt all over, which would still taste fine, but so it's spreadable. Definitely let your brownie cool. And then we're going to come in and top this with our berries. You know, the fun part too, if you did want to really take time, you could do all sorts of fun designs on this.
Yeah.
The recipe calls for 2 to 3 cups of berries and a cup of blueberries, so you could really load this up with berries or go light, depending on what you thought the group you're serving it to would like. Well, Kara, I think that looks perfect and definitely patriotic.
Yes.
Perfect for the holidays and summer fun, right?
It is.
For this red, white, and blue brownie pizza, visit olams.com. Enjoy the day.
Brought to you from the fully operational Wolf Sub-Zero Kitchen at Olam's.